And gamete transfer is just like in the plant reproduction, we have seen that pollination. So what does mean the gamete transfer? You know that semen of the male, that semen is nothing but they are the, having the sperm and the seminal fluid, that it is transferred by the penis to the vagina of the female during copulation or coitus, and this process is called insemination. And the process of fusion of sperm with the ovum is called fertilization. And that semen is released by the penis into the vagina. This is called insemination. And you know that the fusion of sperm with the ovum is called fertilization. And these sperms, they move through the cervix, enter the uterus, and reach the ampullary stomach junction of fallopian tube where the fertilization took place. You can see the route how this sperm enters through vagina, then cervical canal, then uterus, then isthmus, and from the other side the ovary. From the ovary, the ova will come, and it goes in the fimbri, then in infundibulum, then finally in the ampulla. And this ampullary region is a common meeting place for both the male and female gamete. Okay, you can see the picture that how the sperm will move from the vagina, and it's a graphical representation also. So what happens during fertilization? A sperm comes in contact with the zona pellucida, and that is a layer of the ovum, and that induces the changes in the membrane that blocks the entry of the other sperm, and it ensures that only one sperm fertilizes an ovum. And one more thing, that fertilization happens only if ovum and sperm are transported simultaneously. That's the reason that all copulation or coitus do not lead to fertilization and pregnancy. Okay, for that there should be a synchronization that both ova and sperm. That's why in the menstrual cycle there is at the time of the mid of the menstrual cycle there is ovulation. That time is very like favorable. It's if for fertilization. If that time, because ovulation took place in that particular period, and that is fertile period, at that time if there is a coitus, then the chances that the sperm and the ova, they will fuse, and a sperm contact with the zona pellucida, it blocks it changes the membrane that blocks the entry of additional sperm just to avoid polyspermy. The secretion of the acrosome that helps sperms to enter the egg cytoplasm via the zona pellucida and plasma membrane, this cause second meiotic division of the secondary oocyte. You remember in the last video, I told you about that when the ovulation took place, there is a release of secondary oocyte from the graafian follicle during the mid of menstrual cycle, and there is only one meiotic division. And when this acrosome, when the sperm enters into the egg, these induce the second meiotic division of the secondary oocyte that form ovum, that is oated, and second polar body. And this haploid nucleus of the sperm and that of the ovum fuse together to form a diploid zygote. After the fusion of male and female gametes, the zygote will carry either the XX or XY chromosomes. It will depend upon the whether the sperm carrying the X or Y chromosome. You know that male is having the heterogamety. Male will decide the sex of a child. Female are having only the XX. If the zygote carrying XX, that would be develop into female. And if it is carrying a Y, because female is only carrying the X, then it's a male baby. So father is determining the sex of the father is determining the sex of a baby by, but it is not by the mother. Then the zygote will form. The zygote undergo mitotic division. Remember, it is not meiosis. It's a mitotic, it's an equal division. One cell will give rise to two cells. And it mitotic division within zygote termed cleavage. And at the start, the zygote moves toward the uterus through the isthmus of the oviduct. Okay. And it forms 2, 4, 8, 16. Because one zygote will form 2, then 2 will form 4, 4 will form 8, 8 will form 16. And these 16 daughter cells, they are called blastomeres. The cells are called blastomeres. The embryo with 8 to 16 blastomeres is called a morula. and the morula continues to divide and transformed into a blastocyst as it moves further into the uterus. You can see here, in the blastocyst, they are arranged into an outer layer called trophoblast, and the inner cell mass, it's called, that is attached to the trophoblast. The trophoblast layer then get attached to the endometrium of the uterus and inner cell mass get differentiated as a embryo. And it forms three germ layers, like outer ectoderm, then middle mesoderm, and inner is endoderm. And the three layer structure is called gastrula. And that embeddedment of blastocyst in the endometrium is in the uterus is called implantation. Okay. You can see how it is happening. After attachment, this is a uterus structure inside the, like how it will implant it, that zygote, that blastocyst, because it is in the stage of blastocyst. So after implantation, after the attachment, the uterine cell divide rapidly and covers the blastocyst. Okay. As a result, the blastocyst become embedded in the endometrium, and this is called implantation. And after implantation, the following changes occur in the uterus and embryo during pregnancy. The finger-like projections appears on the trophoblast called chorionic villi, that is surrounded by the uterine tissue and maternal blood. You can see the whole picture, how it will happen, like where it will, the fertilization took place. That fertilization took place in the ampullary region. You can see the secondary oocyte comes through the ovulation. You can see the ovary, graafian follicle release the secondary oocyte. It forms the corpus luteum. And then the sperm will come from the opposite side. It will fuse, fertilization took place. Then the zygote will form, and zygote will move towards the uterus. And it is also divided by the same time it formed 2, 4 cells, 8 cells, say it form morula, then blastocyst, and blastocyst is finally embedded into the endometrium of the uterus. That is called implantation. Now, after implantation, the finger-like projection, you can see here, the finger-like projection, that is chorionic villi, appears on the trophoblast, and they are surrounded by the uterine tissue and maternal blood. These are chorionic villi that are shown by the yellow arrow. Okay. Both the uterine tissue and the chorionic villi, they become interdigitated with each other and jointly form a structural and functional unit between developing embryo and maternal body, is called placenta. That placenta will form, you can see the placenta. It is shown by, represented by the, you can see the maternal blood is there, uterus is there, and uterine artery and vein they have shown. And the placenta is a structural and functional unit between embryo and maternal body. Now, the function of placenta, or placenta acts, the placenta transport oxygen and nutrients to the fetus and removes carbon dioxide and excretory waste material produced by it. Placenta also act as a endocrine tissue and secrete hormone like HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin, human placental lactogen, HPL, estrogen, progesterone. Placenta is connected to the embryo by an umbilical cord, and it transports substances to and from the embryo. These are the function of placenta. It acts as a barrier between fetus and mother, supply O2 nutrients from mother to fetus, removes CO2 excretory waste from fetus, act as an endocrine gland. It secretes human chorionic HCG, human HPL, estrogen, progesterone, and relaxin. That is the function of placenta. Placenta is endocrine tissue, and it is a both fetal-maternal tissue, because it is developed from the embryo and maternal body. It's a fetal-maternal, and relaxin is secreted by the ovary in the later phase of pregnancy. Umbilicoidal cord connects the placenta with fetus and help in the transport of substances. And during pregnancy, the level of estrogen, progesterone, cortisol, prolactin, thyroxine, they are increased many times in the maternal body, and they support the fetal growth, metabolic changes in the mother, and maintain pregnancy. You know, in sometimes if the like the pregnancy, the fetus abort within 2 months or 3 months, in that case the doctor will suggest the progesterone. They will give the progesterone injection so that it will maintain the endometrium lining. It will also maintaining the fetal growth. It help in the fetal growth. That's maintenance of pregnancy. Okay. Now the embryonic development starts after pregnancy, and it involves following changes. You know, the inner cell mass, that is a embryo, that differentiated to outer layer called ectoderm, and inner layer is called endoderm, and the middle one is mesoderm. We are triploblastic, that's a three derm, and these germ layers, they give rise to all tissues, organ. And the stem cell is the inner cell mass, have the potency to give rise to the, all the tissues and organs. Nowadays, you know, there's a life care, there are many stem cell technologies. You can store the stem cell for future complications, because the stem cells, they are having the totipotency, and because they are having the potency to give rise to all cells, all the tissue and the organs. They are undifferentiated cells, and only during the delivery we can get through the umbilicoidal blood. And this human pregnancy, the meaning is gestation period. It lasts for 9 months. It depends upon different animals, like cat is 2 months, dog 2 months, elephant 21 months. In humans, after the 1 month of pregnancy, the embryo heart is formed. The first heart is formed. This is a sign of growing fetus, can be measured by listening to the heartbeat after 5th to 7th week of the pregnancy. And by the end of 2nd month, the limbs and digits forms. Digits means that fingers. By the end of 3rd month, means the first trimester, because the 9 months is divided into three: first trimester, second trimester, and third trimester. Or you can say in the 12 weeks or 3 months is the same thing. Either you say 12 weeks, either you say 3 months, either you say first trimester. The major organs like limbs, external genitalia organs, they are well developed. And during the 5th month, or you can say just before the completion of second trimester, the first movement of fetus and appearance of hair on the head are observed. And the end of 6 months, or the second trimester, or 24 weeks, the body is covered with fine hairs, eyelids separate, and eyelashes are formed. And the end of 8 months, the testes in the male fetus descend into the scrotum. And by the end 9 months, the fetus is fully developed and ready for the birth. Okay. Now, parturition. Parturition means it's the process of giving birth to young ones. The process of delivery of fetus is called parturition, the childbirth. And the average duration of human pregnancy, I told you, it's a 9 months. It is called gestation period. And the vigorous contraction of the uterus at the time of end of pregnancy, this cause expulsion or delivery of the fetus. And this is induced by the neuroendocrine mechanism. And this signal, it will start from the fully developed fetus and the placenta. It induces mild uterine contraction, that is called fetal ejection reflex. And this causes the release of oxytocin from maternal pituitary. And relaxin hormone is secreted by the ovary and placenta to facilitate parturition by softening the connective tissue of the Pisces pubica, and this oxytocin, like this, this pituitary will release the oxytocin, and this oxytocin act on the uterine muscle that cause stronger contraction, which in turn stimulate further secretion of oxytocin, and this cause more stronger contraction leading to the expulsion of the baby out of the uterus through the birth canal. And this is the injection, like in this case, like mostly doctor, they will induce this labor pain by using the oxytocin. Like this is an emergency, like if there is any case of any, the chance of the maternal or fetal life, the doctor will give you the induce the labor pain by giving the oxytocin injection. So that oxytocin cause stronger uterine muscle contraction. You know that the uterus in the there are three layers, ecto and meso and endo. That middle layer is having a smooth muscle cell, and that is due to uterine muscle contraction, which in turn stimulate further secretion of oxytocin. And after the baby is delivered, the placenta is also expelled out of the uterus, and the process is continued, leading to the expulsion of body out of the uterus through the birth canal. You know, vagina and cervix, they are made the birth canal. Now, you know, this after parturition, the umbilical cord is cut off. You have seen in the newborn babies, like there is an umbilical cord. The placenta and remnants of the umbilical cord are expelled from the maternal body after the parturition. It is called afterbirth. And the next part is lactation. You know, parturition is followed by the lactation, which requires certain changes in the mother body. The mammary glands, they produce milk towards the end of pregnancy. It is called lactation. And the yellowish milk produced during the initial few days of the lactation is called colostrum. And this colostrum is having several and that will develop resistance to the newborn baby. It will provide the passive immunity. Okay, there are two types of immunity, active or passive. If you make your own antibodies, then it is active. Like nowadays, the corona vaccine, they are inducing you, they are giving you a dead virus. So it means you are making your antibodies, it is active. And the passive one, they are directly giving you the antibodies. So it's a passive immunity, it is provided by the newborn baby, because newborn baby is not exposed to any kind of antigen. So it is, everything is new for them. So it is good to provide the lactation and the feeding the child at least for 6 months to better precaution. This is all about the chapter from my side. Okay. And now 20 minutes are left. So now it is up to you whether I will start some other topic or you will ask, you will try to ask some other question. Yes. May I start the next topic? Or I will take some questions and discuss. Like, I will tell you the different hormones and the function, because we have already covered this chapter. You know that there is the FSH. The role of FSH and LH, we have studied in the male, that LH work on the leading cells and FSH work on the Sertoli cells. The FSH, the source of LH or FSH is the anterior pituitary lobe. And FSH function in a female, it stimulates the growth of ovarian follicle in ovary, as the name follicle stimulating hormone. It stimulates the growth of ovarian follicle in the ovary in the females. Or males, it function on the Sertoli cells. And it will secrete, you know, it will help in spermiogenesis. LH, it triggers ovulation in females. Or males, it works on the leading cells and it increases the secretion of testosterone, androgen, and it promotes for metagenesis. HCG, human chorionic gonadotropin, it is a release by placenta. It stimulates the corpus luteum to secrete progesterone. Relaxin, it is secreted by the placenta. It facilitates parturition by softening the connective tissue of symphysis pubica. Okay, these are the hormones of menstrual cycle and their role. Yes, please ask questions, otherwise I will discuss. Can you tell me how many cells are present in morula? Can you tell me how many cells are present in morula? Morula stage?
Nearly, hello? Sir, 18 to 16 blastomers are present.
Yes, up to 16. Up to 16. And blastocyst? Blastocyst is having how many number of cells?
Up to 8.
64. जो ब्लास्टोसिस्ट बेटे इम्प्लांट होता है ना, दैट इज हैविंग 64 ब्लास्टोमियर्स. जो ब्लास्टोसिस्ट स्टेज है ना, जो यूट्रस में इम्प्लांट होता है, दैट इज 64 स्टेज. 64 सेल्स होती हैं ब्लास्टोसिस्ट में. मोरुला में होती है 16. और जाइगोट में कितनी सेल्स होती हैं? जाइगोट में कितनी सेल्स होती हैं? हेलो, tell me the number of cells in zygote.
Two to 16 daughter cells. After mitotic,
only one cell. We start our life from the single cell, that is zygote, and zygote is a vital connecting link between the two generations. Zygote is having only one cell. Morula is having 16. ब्लास्टोसिस्ट 64. ठीक है, जाइगोट में एक ही सेल होती है बेटा, दैट इज डिप्लॉयड. ओके, नाउ यू टेल मी, नेम द हॉर्मोन्स प्रोड्यूस ओनली ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी इन ह्यूमन फीमेल. नेम द हॉर्मोन दैट प्रोड्यूस ओनली ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी इन ह्यूमन फीमेल. टेल मी द नेम. Hello. Name the hormone produced only during pregnancy in human female.
Sir, progesterone.
The first one is HCG, that is chronic human chronic gonadotropin, and HPL. देखो जो मार्केट में जो किट आती है ना, जो कार्ड टेस्ट हम करते हैं यूरिन से करते हैं ना, जो प्रेगनेंसी टेस्ट होता है, इट इज बेस्ड ऑन द एचसीजी, ह्यूमन कोरोनिक गोनाडोट्रोपिन, दैट इज एचसीजी. तो एचसीजी, एचपीएल और रिलैक्सिन, ठीक है, ये इससे रिलीज होते हैं ओनली ड्यूरिंग द प्रेगनेंसी. लेकिन ऐसा नहीं है, कुछ एबनॉर्मल कंडीशंस में हो सकता है कि कुछ और भी, दिस हार्मोन कैन ऑल्सो रिलीज विदाउट प्रेगनेंसी, बट जनरली दिस हार्मोन प्रोड्यूस ओनली ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी. And the source of HCG and HPL is placenta, or relaxin ka jo source hai, that is ovary and placenta. ठीक है, placenta जो है वो फीटो मेटर्नल है, endocrine tissue, फीटो मेटर्नल placenta बना है, maternal से भी और fetus से भी. Relaxin secrete करता है ovary भी और placenta भी, और जबकि HCG और HPL वो सिर्फ placenta secrete करता है. ठीक है, relaxin का function क्या है? What is the function of relaxin? Relaxin hormone is secreted by the ovary and placenta. It facilitates parturition by softening the connective tissue of symphysis pubica. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, My next question is, what stimulates pituitary to release the hormone responsible for parturition? Name the hormone. What stimulates pituitary to release the hormone responsible for parturition? Name the hormone.
Sir, oxytocin.
That is the oxytocin's correct answer. The fetal ejection reflex stimulates pituitary to release the hormone responsible for parturition, and the hormone is oxytocin. जो last में जब किसी को labor pain हो रहा होता है, जो completely labor pain को induce करने के लिए भी हम जो doctors injection दिया जाता है, वो क्या होता है? Oxytocin ही होता है. ठीक है? What is colostrum? What is colostrum?
It is basically a milk which is produced during the initial few days.
Acha, it is a initial, you know, in the first, it is a thin yellowish, and it in the initial, you know, the first milk which come out from the mother mammary just after the child, it is rich in proteins and having the IgA antibodies that provide passive immunity to the newborn. And this immunity helps the newborn to attain resistance to many infections. This feeding is very recommended for the infant growth by the doctors for bringing up disease-free or healthy baby. Now, tell me, where does fertilization occur in humans? कहाँ पे होती है fertilization in humans? एम्पुलरी रीजन, लेकिन अगर हम थोड़ा सा और देखें तो इट इज एम्पुलरी इस्टेमिक जंक्शन ऑफ द फेलोपियन ट्यूब. ठीक है, इट इज इन द एम्पुलरी, द करेक्ट आंसर इज करेक्ट, एम्पुलरी इस्टेमिक जंक्शन ऑफ द फेलोपियन ट्यूब. नाउ यू कैन ऑल्सो आस्क द क्वेश्चन,
सर व्हाट इज क्लीवेज?
क्लीवेज डिवीजन को बोलते हैं. देखो जो यहाँ पे मैंने बताया था क्लीवेज हो रही है, देखो जैसे माइटोसिस हो रही है, माइटोसिस को क्या बोलते हैं? क्लीवेज. ये देखो यहाँ पे क्या था? जाइगोट था. जाइगोट से क्या हुआ? एक से दो बने, माइटोसिस हुई, दो से चार सेल बनी, चार से आठ सेल बनी, तो उसको बोलते हैं क्लीवेज. ये देखो That is mitotic division. Zygote undergo mitotic division. इसी mitotic division को हम क्या बोल रहे हैं? Cleavage. ठीक है, यहाँ meiosis नहीं हो रही, यहाँ पे क्या हो रही है? Mitosis, because we are diploid and zygote is always diploid. तो यहाँ पे एक से दो बन रही है. Meiosis में क्या होता है? एक से चार बनती हैं और वहां पे haploid बनते हैं. Diploid से haploid, chromosome number half हो जाता है. यहाँ पे chromosome number same रहेगा. Cleavage is nothing but say mitotic division. और कुछ? जो morula stage है,
what is the meaning of decapsidation?
Decapsidation. Where it is decapsidation?
Yes, sir.
Or capacitation? You are saying decapsidation?
Yes, sir. Decapsidation.
देखो capsidation word तो वहां पे आता है जब sperms को mature होने के लिए, जब जैसे epididymis में जब sperms store होते हैं and they are actively they are mature, तो that word capsidation word is there. For maturity of sperm, we use the word capacitation. But decapacitation, I have not read decapacitation. Might be opposite to the capacitation. Capacitation, I know. In which context you are asking of this chapter or what decapacitation? Where it is like in the NCERT you have written, you have seen
Sir, no, I read from a question.
You can read the question, full question. Capacitation is for the maturation of sperm.
Okay, sir.
That is capacitation. So decapacitation is just opposite to, I think, that. Capacitation to mature होने से related है sperm का, क्योंकि epididymis में क्या होता है, sperm कुछ time के लिए store होते हैं ताकि वो actively और उनकी जो functioning है वो थोड़ा they will get mature. बेटा frankly मैं आपको बताऊं कि मैं जितना NCERT में है उतना तो मैं थोड़ा बहुत अच्छे से जानता हूं, but beyond that I frankly admit that my knowledge is not of NEET level. Okay, you can consider me only up to the 12th or NCERT level. Okay, I am still reading. So for some reasons like I am good for the 12th as per NCERT syllabus, but I will if you send me the question, I will try to find out the answer. Hello, any other thing?